Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, Song of the Ocean, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We got some books or something here. Water Tribe Prelude. Leon Friedrich Richter, opera Water Tribe from Prelude First Flight. They dropped off to sleep and the new generation came. It's time to take a first flight. People, the long generation of being a baby bird is over. Tomorrow, glory and destruction will come at your own discretion. Fly, fly away. Oh look, the sky's endlessly spreading. Create the new history. Are the humans flapping their wings to freedom? Okay, Act 1. Leon Friedrich Richter, opera Water Tribe, Act 1. Act 1, Scene 1, Seek Your Dream. What do you wish for? Walk on your own and live the joy and suffering for yourself. Seek out your dreams for a bright future. Act 1, Scene 2, Like God. Oh, the wise men by the water, the power you generate is the people's work in place of God's. Look, dawn shot up from the ocean. Act 1, Scene 3, The Power of Miracle. Oh, the almighty tunes, which are the power of miracles. Please promise me the everlasting glory to the one who plays the tunes. Alright. Act 2. Act 2, Scene 1, Paradise. Live in splendor. The prime time of my life has come. My long-lasting wish was rewarded. Let's go seek for the further world ahead of us. Act 2, Scene 2, The Unknown World. It's the gate that leads you to the unknown world. Now there's a door in front of us to the new world. Fly ahead to the unknown world. Act 2, Scene 3, The Blue Within. Everyone feels blue deep inside. It's an endless sanction and the world within, which is the world of blue similar to deep abyss. Righto. We just read 2 or 3? Okay. Act 3, Scene 1, Dark Sun. Is the sun that lapped the dark flames the sign of deception because man gives way to the temptation of the power, or because they seek for paradise? Act 3, Scene 2, Disaster Without a Sign. Something was born as many of the dreams came true. Good or bad, disasters without a sign were sneaking up on them. Act 3, Scene 3, Sinful Ones Among Us. You won't see it wherever you look, but it's among us. Why haven't we been able to notice such a big mistake? Alright, 4. We got 4, 5, 6, and then the finale. And then we'll be going into those embassies. Act 4, Scene 1, Arch Enemy. Oh, there's that Arch Enemy again. Oh, finally, the Arch Enemy was born among man. Now, where are we supposed to be heading? Act 4, Scene 2, Otherworldly Moon. The sun which lapped the dark flame now flipped the moon. My last wish is the power to do it myself. Act 4, Scene 3, The Gap of the Earth. From what did the deep gap of the earth separate us? Even though everything is forgotten, this scar will remain as long as this world lasts. Okay, I think we're on 5 now. Act 5, Scene 1, Accountability of the Man. Since when did the man carry their sins? Don't call me the blind sheep. The traveler to happiness slided into a sinner. Slided into a sinner. Act 5, Scene 2, The People of Skills. Shut your mouth, but keep it within your memory. Even though all the other people forget, only you should remember the reason. Act 5, Scene 3, The One That Inherits the Vessel. Sink the tower of the field of sea into the ocean and make it part of the history in the bottom of the water. The sunken vessel is a tombstone of the ephemeral dreams. Alright. So we just read this, right? Yeah. Okay, Act 6. Act 6, Scene 1, Carrying Karma. They had left for the world in blue, far, far away. Those who remained knew that they were not alone in bearing their karma. Act 6, Scene 2, Like God. Thinking of brothers, play the soft tunes again tonight, the tunes which are neither refined nor powerful. They only exist to long for the past. Act 6, Scene 3. Look at the moon. To the moon floating over the dark world, the sun which lapped the dark flames is now deep down. The tower of the field of the sea is in the bottom of ocean. If the time comes again when the dark flames float up in the heavenly sky, look into the moon of your heart. Oh, shining in the heavenly sky, the black light of dark sun, look at the sky, or you'll be saved. I don't understand any of this. Look at the sky, or you'll be saved. Okay, so we can't look at the sky, because we need to be saved. Water Tribe Finale. Tinkle the Melodies. Sleep, wise men by the water. Sleep under the deep blue world. Or getting lost in the steep mountains, the applause will never stop to laud your courage or seal it with your hand. Play the melodies, the tunes of wisdom and courage which echo in the field of the sea. Oh, the applause will never stop, as if the heart echoed endlessly. Fascinating. Alright, let's go to the one of the two embassies here. Is that the first one? Let's see, yeah. You have a passport issued by Great Rung. I see. Please come in. In we come. Oops. The butler says, "Welcome to the Embassy of Buridane. How may I help you?" McBain says, "We would like to get a visa." "Please show me the passport from Letteratudo." Forte and his friends handed over the passport. "What's the purpose of the entry?" "We're on a tour," says Forte. "Tour, I see. Please come this way."
"Walk this way."
"What?" The dog left. "Please wait here. I'll make arrangements." Here come arrangements. Ambassador Gareno says, "Ah, excuse me. I'm Gareno, Ambassador of Buridane. I have a quick question for you." "Go right ahead," McBain says. "I've always wondered, but what is the difference between troubadours and artists?" "Pretty much the same. The only difference is that if your performance is centered on playing music, you're a troubadour. And if it is centered in acrobats and skits, you're an artist." "I see. Thanks. It was a big help." "I doubt it really helped," says Forte. "Thank you for waiting. The procedure to enter Buridane is completed. Here it is." Forte and his friends receive a passport. Alright, does it look different? Oh, that's right, we have now new entries. Enter Buridane. What about the exit? We'll be stuck there forever. I'm the acting ambassador when it... Ambassador Gareno is not in the office. I'm feeling nervous. Alright. Helper says, "It's not easy to be an officer, is it?" Well, is it? "Do you know Rish Campbell? He's a rich man who's been scooping up islands here and there these days. I heard that he built a big mansion on Ryutam Island. He's a bad guy, but an influential person. I was invited to the party upon completion of the mansion. Sometimes it's not fun to be a public servant." Okay. Oh, can't get out that way. Alright, I guess we're off to the next embassy. Excuse me. I'm already in. See if there's anything around here. Next embassy. Not it yet. You have a passport issued by Great Rung. I see. Please come in. He says the exact same thing the other guy says. Let's hope these people say something new. You can go through a procedure to enter the Principality of Pensola from Graysol at the checkpoint on the border. If you make a declaration there, they'll get ready for you. I probably want that butler, but I want to look over here. Ambassador Bios. He loads up when the computer is started. Since Graysol and Letteratudo are allied, a visa is not really necessary. It's only obligated to put the brake on criminals entering the country. Oh, you are? You're Forte, the second prize winner of the Pinzel recital, right? Yes. You did an awesome job. I voted for you too. Thank you very much. Cool, Forte, says Una. You're quite a celebrity now. I see. You're gonna seriously start your training as a troubadour. You have a bright future ahead of you. Welcome to the Embassy of Graysol. We're here to obtain a visa, Bane says. Please show me your passport. Forte and his friend showed the passport. Thank you. Let me stamp your visa. Here. Forte and his friends receive a passport. It was really easy, says Una. Letteratudo and Graysol are allied countries, so it's not a complicated procedure. Alright, so now we have an enter Graysol. And Birdine. Graysol is a wonderful country. Please have a good trip. Now what? We leave? We might be leaving now. Sure. Let's see, if they stop us, then we're not done with everything in here. Forte, wait! This is Perret. You're a fan again, McBean says. Were you gonna leave me like that? You're mean, says Nira. I'm mean? McBean says, it doesn't look like she will let you go. Okay, how about this? Let us perform in the Water Fountain Square to show our fans our great appreciation. Then maybe everyone will pray for the safety of our tour and send us off. Yahoo, says Kathy. Are you going to play for us? Yeah, says Forte. Will you promise? McBean says. Perry says, okay. Maddie says, all right, I understand. Oh, there's three of those scruffy guys now. I forgot to go talk to him. I forgot all about him, actually. Jiri says, hee, a good opportunity has come. Are you ready? Zab says, gotcha. We're going to rob from the girls who are getting caught up in the music, right? Ouch. Too loud, says Jiri. Dak says, you're smart, bro. Jiri says, stay alert. McBean says, well, what should I do? However, people want to hear Forte perform. Let's play I'm Fine. Wow, great, says Maddie. Those nasty cup purses. Jerry says, hee hee hee, I gotta be sneaky. What are you doing? Says Maddie. Ah! Wow, she's pretty strong, huh? Zab says, haha, you blew up! Nira says, get out of my way! Haha, awesome. Dak says, leave it to me! Dory says, go away! Jerry says, who are they? They're fans. This is the best part, says Tyria. That was one whole part. Jerry says, we ended up... Zab says, after all... Dak says, being beat up. We won't forget this, says Jerry. I don't think you would. Thank you very much, says Forte. Cute, says Perrette. Dory says, fantastic, you're the best. McBain says, I'm now going to leave Letteratudo from the pier in Fargo to go on a world tour. Nira says, then we'll send you off to the port. No, no. I appreciate it, but if you come, it wouldn't be good for Forte's training. Please understand, for Forte's sake, and see us off from here. Okay, says Kathy. Perret says, we'll do it for Forte. McBain says, okay, let's break up here then. We understand, says Maddie, because we are good fans who have manners. Yeah, you keep saying that. Tyrius says, good luck on your tour. McBain says, thank you. It's time for you to break up now. Oops, sorry about that. Oh my god, now it's happening with this headset. Phew, says McBain. I was surprised at how popular Forte is. It's good to be popular as a musician, but you need to be popular because of your skills. I know, says Forte. McBain says, you're not as popular as I used to be when I was young, though. Well, if we don't hurry, you're gonna get caught. Let's head to Fargo. Did I say anything else? Saying the same stuff about this one. I think that's what he said before too, so let's go. Off to Fargo. Sunbarl Road, okay. Oh, the dog still has that shield on. Clubby? We got clubbies. A and B. I think Jan knocked him too far. Yep. Yeah, whatever, just hit him. McBain says, oops. Lori says, thank you very much. No problem. What wonderful weather we have here. Right. Excuse me. Forte says, you didn't yield because she was a young lady, did you? By necessity. What do you mean by that? Says Una. Forte says in this case he has admitted that he yielded to her because she was a young lady. Only you could figure that out, Forte. Because we have known each other for a long time. Okay. Oh, a chest. Orb of Ocean 10. Yeah. A marble with an image of McBain smiling can be viewed in the Ocean album. Why would a random picture of McBain be in this chest? Huh. It's like it recorded him. Attack! We destroy. Pen, pen, and clubbies. Interrupt here. Oh, break this? Wait, we can't get to that. Never mind. I thought this could be something we'd break with the rock smash technique. Finishing move, what have you. More pen pens. Or one pen pen and clubbage. We kill the things. Do we come from here? I think so, yeah. I remember this stuff. Those little things on the beach that you think you can interact with, but you can't. Thank you. Yeah, the idea is to interrupt the enemy. So I think you attack the one you're interrupting. But, I don't know. When you're interrupting a character, like, who are you attacking then? Yeah. The enemy was very surprised. I don't know if I'll use it this time. Yeah. Didn't even get to it. The enemy didn't even get to go, so I couldn't interrupt them. Alright, so there's another monster over there, and we got this area. It's the only way we can go, okay. Okay. I wonder how far this place away. This place is. This place away? What the hell? What is this? Like a tuning fork. What is this? A tuning fork? Says Forte. Yes, it's a tuning fork, says Una. Why is it here? Something may happen if we perform in front of this. Do you want to try? Una says. Yes. The tuning fork resonated in harmony, and the light wrapped Forte and his friends. Whoa. The hell? Forte says, where am I? Forte, says Una. Oracle? An oracle? Says, finally, you're here, adventurers. Ah, says Forte. Oh. I haven't seen you here before, Oracle says. I'm sure someone briefed you at the guild, but let me give you an overview again. This place was built jointly by the Adventurer Guild and the Bardis Church. Oh, interesting. It's a kind of training ground for people to forge their mind and body. You'll experience the simplified version of the great adventure of Avon, the famous adventurer. Sweet, to become a better adventurer yourself. Okay. So this is, referring back to A Tear of Vermillion. Says Forte. Yes? What are the Adventurer Guild and the Bardis Church? Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were adventurers from El Phildin. We're troubadours from Weltluna. We're not really adventurers. I see. So how did you come here? Una says, Forte played his cithara in front of this tuning fork and we suddenly floated on air. Before we knew it, we were here. Oh, so you're not from Phildin. My apologies. What is he talking about, Forte? Says Una. I have no idea. I'm sorry, I believe you're very rare visitors in this place. If you can, please help us by using this place again. Forte says, this is a place where we can experience an adventure, right? Yes, it is. I understand. I'll help you. Forte, you can't say yes that easily, says Una. Then let me briefly explain how things work in this place. Just ask me, and I'll take you to various training grounds. But you must qualify to go to each training ground. Only I can give you qualifications. To receive a qualification, you must convince me that you deserve it. I shall identify your possibilities and provide you with new encounters. I shall help you reunite the people you have met in the past. This is all different ones talking. Okay, understood. Oh, one more thing. If you stand at the entrance to this place, you'll probably be able to return to where you came from. Well, good luck. Says Una. With your level now, you can try until this point. Capital Road Monster? Who's that there? Road to the Capital. This is the music from A Tear of Vermillion. Do you want to go back? No, I guess that goes back to the oracles. Wow, we can fight these things. We surprised them. One shot it. Missed. We got Hunter Book 1. Well, it's not in the under books. Is it a music book? No. Adventurer's book published in Phildin. You'll never miss your targets. Can't read it or use it in any other way, it looks like. So funny to hear the Tear of Vermillion music again. How dare you, miss? Sorcerer's Book 1. Read this and you'll feel like a master sorcerer uses light cactus. I do not know how to use it. Oh my! Oh, we're fighting that thing? I forget what this thing's called. Oh no, giant beach car gas.